All right, I'm going to hit you with the definition first.
Hit me.
So conditional independence is this idea that goes like this. We're going to say that some variable that makes up the joint distribution is conditionally independent of some other variable, y, given z, if it's the case that the probability distribution governing x, so the probabilities associated with the values in this variable x, is independent of the value of y given the value of z. If I tell you what z is, then you can figure out what the probability of x is without having to look at y. So that is, if it's the case that for all possible values, little x, little y, and little z, for the variables big X, big Y, and bz, if it's the case that the probability that big X, the random variable big X, takes on the value little x, given that big Y takes on the value little y, and big Z takes on the value little z, equals the probability that big X takes on the value x, given big Z takes on the value of z, if those are equal for all possible ways of filling in the values of the variables, then we say that x is conditionally independent of y given z, right? So you see we dropped y from the right-hand side of the probability expression, okay? So it's sort of less things that we have to worry about if it's the case that we really didn't need it in the first place.
Fewer.
Fair enough.
So that's pretty similar to normal independence.
Okay, so what's normal independence?
So normal independence, we say the probability of x and y is equal to the probability of x times the probability of y.
That's right.
Which means if we think about the chain rule, we also know that the probability of x and y is equal to the probability of x given y times the probability of y. So that means that the probability of x given y is equal to the probability of x for all values of x and y.
So this is actually implying, if it equals that, that means that px times py equals px given y times py. We cancel those. We get px equals. Okay, so that's what you wanted to say.
Right. So since what independence means, right, is that the joint distribution between two variables is equal to the product of their marginals. And that's just, you know, comes from basic probability theory. And so if you think about what that means from the chain rule point of view, it's like saying the probability of x given y is equal to the probability of x. So it looks just like the equation you wrote down for conditional independence.
Right. The only thing that we added is this notion that it might be the case that we don't have such a strong property as this, where it's always the case that you can write the probability of x given y just with the probability of x. But in the context of knowing some value z, it might be true. And that's what conditional independence gives us. As long as there is some z that we can stick in here that gives us that property, that's great. We can essentially ignore y when we're talking about the probability of x.
Okay, that's pretty cool. That seems more powerful or something.
Yeah, and in fact, remember you mentioned the word factoring. You can see here that we're writing down a probability as the product of two other things. We're factoring that probability distribution. That's what independence lets us do, and conditional independence lets us do it in more general circumstances. So let's apply this concept back to what we were just talking about before.
Okay,